Greetings, people of Paul Mocker here. Today is January 16, 2014. As some of you know, I went to court today to face my terror charges they have against me. But people, I have the court recording, right? When I was arrested back in May 2002, I have the court recording. I want y'all to hear it. And after it finished, I'm going to give y'all my opinion, tell y'all what it's all about, okay? So listen to the tape first, and then I'll come back and tell y'all. I want y'all to hear how the United States government, the federal marshal and a federal judge, and the Massachusetts government have set me up, okay? And when y'all finish watching, I'll tell y'all what happened. I'm going to bleep out certain names because I'm not allowed to mention the weasel, okay? So I cannot mention the weasel, so the names are bleeped out. So here's the tape. When it finishes, I'm going to come back. One love.
Yes, very good.
Mr.
Okay, so we'll hold that.
What's his
name? I don't know if I have that paperwork yet. Let me take a look. Oh.
What's his name? How do you spell it?
Oh, Paul Muckle.
Paul Muckle defaulted on H 25, 2012 at the time. He had 3 men. He was scheduled to be at courtroom 11.
You're saying your contact, the alleged victim sent you.
Okay, good afternoon, Mr. Muckle.
Yes.
Commonwealth's position on this, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. Shield on behalf of the Commonwealth. Your Honor, just to inquire, according to our records, we had a pretrial hearing date of July 5th already scheduled for this person.
We have a default on with a warrant on May 2nd.
May 2nd. Okay, thank
good day.
You.
What default?
Thank you, Your Honor.
What?
The Commonwealth asks that the defendant just read and sign a bail warning.
What?
Okay, just hold on for a second.
One second.
They're not asking you to be held.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Thank you.
But hold on a second, let's see what the judge says. Hmm? Hold on just a second, let's see what the judge says here.
Yes, because I wanted them to keep it, to hold it. But his name was erased. I erased his name already. I have a video showing me erasing his name because I didn't trust him. But I said, people, I think my hearing could happen.
Okay, well, I'm not adopting that recommendation. So what can you tell me?
Well, I've spoke with Mr. Muckle, and it was his understanding that he was supposed to be here in July for a hearing. He got a summons to be here for tomorrow for another case. It was his understanding that a hearing on a restraining order was taking place on
25th.
April the 25th, but that he did not oppose the restraining order. And did not believe he had to appear for that.
Okay, the one who opposed it. Can I speak? Can I speak, maybe? Let me speak.
Okay, we'll call this again at 2 o'clock or thereafter. I'd like the Commonwealth to look into this.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you.
Further call.
Further call.
We'll see if there's another case pending and have you look at it if there is.
Yes. Thank you, Your Honor.
Your Honor, can I just make sure it's Paul L. Muckle?
It is.
Thank you. And can the Commonwealth reserve the opportunity to re-argue bail once we...
You may.
Thank you.
Do we have Ms. Sanders from...
Oh, God.
Just hang tight. We'll look at what it says.
Okay.
So the Commonwealth's position on this, please. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Your Honor. Thank you. Spencer Lovey of Commonwealth, and thank you for the second call. Your Honor, this is a matter that I had called forward on April 25th, just a few days ago, actually before Your Honor in Room 11, and I requested a warrant for violations of the conditions of the defendant's bail warning. The defendant, my understanding is that the defendant was arrested yesterday by the Brockton Police Department. At this time, I do have a motion to revoke the defendant's bail.
You may.
Just to give Your Honor some of the background, essentially, Mr. Muckle was involved in a lawsuit. My understanding was that at least part of it took place in federal court, involved a federal judge, Justice Woodlock. It also involved an attorney named. I believe there were a series of lawsuits, but they all revolved around the foreclosure on Mr. Muckle's home, which took place, I believe, today. As a result of that, Mr. Muckle is alleged to have made a number of threats, both to that federal justice as well as to those threats involve threats to kill. The Federal Marshal Service is currently investigating Mr. Muckle. The details of that are in the original incident report as well as the supplemental incident report, and I've attached both to the motion to revoke. I've also attached an email, which is the basis of the motion to revoke. On the arraignment date of April 17th, Judge Driscoll did issue a stay-away, no-contact order, and as Your Honor can clearly see, there is an email date-stamped after April 17th from Mr. Muckle to a number of people, including the attorney. Which in the Commonwealth's mind is a clear violation of the no-contact order. Given that, Your Honor, the Commonwealth is moving to revoke the defendant's bail. The defendant does have a 5-page record, which includes some extensive committed time for crimes of violence. He has a number of serious charges, many of which were null pros or dismissed, but serious charges nonetheless. He also has a number of defaults on his record. Given the nature of the threats, which, as I say, are threats to kill, as well as the nature of the defendant's record, the Commonwealth believes that moving to revoke is appropriate. Additionally, Your Honor, the Commonwealth is renewing its original request for a $20,000 cash bail, as well as a stay-away, no-contact order, and the bail warning, which are already in place.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chambly?
Your Honor, I believe the email that the Commonwealth has referenced is in the file. As you'll note, it's addressed to, and I haven't counted, but I would suggest 30 or more people. It's apparent from the email that it includes as well. The first two people noted there are attorneys who have represented or do represent Mr. Muckle. It's apparent he sent this to everyone in his address book, and that if it went, it was solely an accident and incidental to this communication that he was trying to send out to everyone in his contacts list. He did not realize that he was sending it to Ms. It does not reference, it does not make any threats of any sort. in there. And I don't think that this, while if it was received by me, could be maybe a technical violation of the order, was any intentional violation of the order or any violation of consequence. I'd also note, I've looked through the entire record, there's one conviction on the defendant's record. It's from 1998. Every other case is either not guilty or dismissal. So it's not the, there is no history of violence reflected by this record. This record does not reflect a history of defaulting as well. I would suggest, Your Honor, that this is the record reflects at least on the three of the four counts as it shows it as a default. This was not a default. I do not believe it was a warrant issued on the 25th because of this email. But again, this email being what it is, Mr. having been contacted accidentally, I would ask Your Honor not to revoke Mr. Munkle's bail. I would also note that he was scheduled to, it was his intention to be here tomorrow on a summons that he had received from this court, and I don't know if that relates to this email or to what he thought that it did, but it was his understanding that he was to be here tomorrow for some matter that he was summoned for.
I can speak to that, Your Honor. The victim in the matter is very fearful. He's been in contact with me a number of times. He's also been in contact with the assigned detective, Detective Milette of the A1 district. On the day that this email was sent, he met me at the office about 9 a.m. Detective Milette came over. They filled out a new police report, and they did take out a charge for violation of a restraining order, which the victim did have in effect when this email was sent. So that would likely be the charge that's to be arraigned tomorrow, if that's accurate.
Mr. Clausen? He's saying that it's a brand new case. It's one for which there was probably a clerk's hearing.
Once the clerk's hearing is it'll be in the computer.
And it's not in the computer.
You want no bail at $1,000 bail. No bail at $1,000 bail.
Well, he's asking for a bail, but I don't think there should be a bail.
So would you repeat again your understanding of the so-called new charge?
Yes, Your Honor. The morning that this email was sent, the victim came to our office downstairs and showed it to me, essentially. He then, that morning, actually spoke with the detective assigned, which is Detective Milette. They completed a police report, and Detective Milette was going to apply for new charges for violation of a restraining order because at that time, the victim had a restraining order in place against Mr. Muckle. I'm not sure if there's been perhaps he was sent a summons for tomorrow. I'm not sure what the status of the case is, but I know that the detective does plan to apply for new charges if he hasn't done so already.
Okay, all right, thank you. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
Yes, Your Honor. Your Honor,
you, sir, Mr. Chen.
Mr. Your Honor, was end at 12 midnight to 25th. Right? Look at the time he was sent to that. So it was, there was no official order.
The restraining order was entered.
And I wasn't here because I wanted him to have it. Right. I wanted him to have it.
Again, he tells me that he believed that he had removed this name from his contact list before this. He had recorded himself, in fact, taking it off so that he would have a record of it, and he doesn't understand how it went out to him along with all these other people.
Okay, the motion to revoke the defendant's bail is allowed.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Bail is set on the underlying case at $1,500 cash.
What?
$1,500 cash, but bail's been removed.
So I can't pay it anyway?
No. I make bail for 60 days.
Your Honor, may I speak? Just for 2 seconds.
You may not.
The benefit of a doubt, Your Honor?
No, sir. Just like your attorney, yeah.
looking at on this case and on the underlying when the bail warning is over, it's going to be 50,000. So do you have a 60-day date?
May 25th.
For what?
Huh?
For what?
For pretrial hearing.
So, I'm going
in, Your Honor, I would also like to file a motion for a protective order.
I could try to resolve it on that day.
No, can be before.
Okay,
can
you may do so.
Bail
hearing?
Thank you. Can you give me a bail hearing, sweetie, bail hearing?
But I can have the bail reviewed, but you're held without bail for 60 days.
So when is the bail hearing? I have to be 60 days after?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. On the Paul Muckle number, Paul Muckle matter, 2012 CR 1755. Commonwealth's motion to revoke the defendant's bail on this matter has been allowed. You're going to be held without bail on a probation, on a violation of court order for a period of 60 days to June 29th, 2012. After that, the bail will revert to $1,500 cash. And there are, the Commonwealth has submitted a motion for a protective order, which has been
May 24th, please.
May 24th?
Yes, please.
Mr. Thank you.
Mr. Chambly, do you have anything to say about this motion for a protective order?
No, Your Honor.
Okay, that is allowed.
Thank you, Your Honor.
May 24th. Thank you. When I call your name, please stand.
So, people, did you all hear what that district attorney just accused me of? You all heard with your own ears that he accused me of threatening to kill a federal judge. You all also heard him say that I'm under investigation by the federal marshal. Okay, now people, watch me show you guys, right? Watch me prove to you guys how diabolical and evil, okay, this federal judge, this weasel, the Boston Police and the Suffolk County District Attorney's Office are. Let me show you just how far they went to try to destroy this black man here. Let me show you guys what these guys did, how they teamed up against me, and how Eric Holder, the United States Attorney, Eric Holder's office, declined. Okay? They declined to prosecute me. I'm going to show you all how this judge, this federal judge, went behind Eric Holder's office, went behind their backs, and went to the Boston police and had and lied on me, deliberately lied on me, fabricated evidence against me, and accused me of threatening to kill him when all I did was speak out against him. Let me show it to you guys. Okay. First of all, let me say this. All the information I'm about to give you all is given to you under the Freedom of Information Act. My attorney wrote a letter to the U.S. attorney under the Freedom of Information Act to demand some of the information I'm about to show you guys. And it was approved. So the document I'm about to show you guys, not this email you're looking at, but some of the documents was given to me by the United States attorney. Okay, people, what you are looking at right now, right, is an email that was sent to me by United States Marshal Service. Now, you all heard the DA said I was under investigation by U.S. Marshal. And he was right, I was. Because the U.S. Marshal came to my house one night, just in all black, a whole team of them, came to my house to question me. To make a long story short, I let him in my house. Because I know once I let him in my house, they're going to be under my powers. So, they came in my house and they told me what was going on. And they asked me if I was trying to start a revolution in America. And I tell them, yeah. But not a bloody one. A spiritual one. And I explained everything to them, what was going on about my mortgage suit and everything. So anyway, people, they were so impressed by my presentation of what my goal were that they said, Paul, man, we're with you. He said, we can't have nothing happen to you. We cannot allow anything to happen to you. So we're going to tell the truth. He said, these federal judges, they are afraid of you. these weasel attorneys, they are afraid of you. Because they don't, you're not intimidated by them. So therefore that makes you a very dangerous person. You're not afraid to go to prison. You're not afraid to die. You're not afraid to lose your home. You're not going to take any bribery or payoffs. That makes you very dangerous. So, and we cannot do anything to you because we like your style. However, we have a job to do. And we're going to tell you that right now. Watch what you say about this federal judge and this weasel attorney. Say whatever you want, Paul. Keep talking. But watch what you say about them because they're ready to pounce on you. So keep talking, say everything you're saying, keep fighting for all of us. Keep fighting. We hope you win. God, you win, we all win. But remember, we have a job to do. So our job is to protect these judges. And if you say anything bad about them, we're not going to come because we don't want to hurt you, but others are going to come. And when they come, they're not going to be nice like us. They will hurt you. So watch what you're saying. So people, they asked me if they could come and visit me sometimes to make sure I was okay. And I said, yeah, sure. You know, I said, yeah, come burn some ganja with me. I told them, you could come and burn some ganja with me. It's in your report too. So anyway, they gave me, as time go on, they gave me the email address and they gave me a cell phone number. They said, call us anything, every time the bank send you a letter or anything, anytime the police show up at your door, just call us quickly because we know what's going to happen. We cannot afford for that to happen. We cannot afford for you to get hurt, and we don't want you to hurt anybody. So anytime they show up at your door to try to get your house, call us immediately. If you get a letter from them, call us, and we're going to take care of it. So people, this federal marshal, they protected me for a few months, but at the same time, they were setting me up, which I didn't mind because I knew that either way, I'm going to be set up. So why let them set me up? Why not participate in my own setup? I know I'm going to go down. I know the only way I'm going to escape this is if I give up my case. And I wasn't going to give up. So I know it's going to be set up. And I decided, well, okay, me and my wife decided, okay, they're going to set me up. Take part in your own setup. So what I did, I befriended the U.S. Marshal and I fed them information, knowing that they're going to go back and tell these weasels and these wolves. So I fed the flock to slaughter, in particular, two of the sheep. So the federal marshal went back and told him everything I said, but people had never once said, call any names. I never once told him I'm going to kill anybody or slaughter anybody. I did what they tell me. I did not call any name, and I was not specific. I used the weather and my God. So anyway, as you all hear the district attorney say, I was arrested on April 13th, and I got bail on April 17th. When I came out, people, they arrested me for making threats to this judge and the weasel. When I came out, my house was broken in, and a lot of stuff was stolen, but I'm going to fast, people. I was arrested on April 13th, but on March 24th, I had an intuition that they was coming for me. So I sent Matthew Dumas, at the federal marshal, Protective Internet News. I sent him an email saying, is this goodbye? Okay? And he sent me an email. He said, be strong. One day things must get better. He was quoting Bujo Banton. So people, this is a federal marshal, a white guy, Matthew Dumas. I felt that something was going to happen. They'll come get me. So I said, is this goodbye? And he sent me back, said, be strong. One day things must get better. So, you know, I felt a little better. So then people, a few weeks later on April 13, they came and got me. And they kidnapped me. And the judge in Brockton, they arrested me in Brockton. The judge in Brockton ordered them to take me to Boston to get bail. But the people kidnapped me and took me to Plymouth County Jail and held me there until the court was over. Lied to me until my court was closed at 12 o'clock. And took me to Plymouth Jail to keep me locked up over the weekend. Because I was planning to sell my house on April 17. So they think that I will be held for threatening a federal judge. I won't get out in time to make bail. But on April 17, my powers and will were so strong. I got out around 11 o'clock. I bailed out. And a personal. The only condition was that I stay away from this weasel and the wolf. And I did not agree to it. I didn't sign the bail agreement. That's why you all hear the DA slick and ask the judge to force me to resign it. Because I never agreed to it. I never agreed to stay away from this weasel and this wolf. I never agreed not to contact them. I didn't agree to it. You forced me to sign it after the fact. and you used it to revoke my bail. So I got that against you. Anyway, so people are sending U.S. Marshal a letter saying, house broken into, $40,000 cash in Margaret Rizzo sterling, my antiques stolen, my computer stolen, my doors destroyed, my sanctuary defiled, Judas has kissed me. So people, I'm accusing the federal marshal of setting me up. So anyway, remember I told you all right that they gave me their cell phone number and the email address to call them in case I was in trouble, because they said they'll come, if I ever got locked up, they'll come to court and tell the judge that I'm, speak for me. They promised me they'll come to court and speak on my behalf. It's not that I believe them, but still, they were my conduit. They were the one who taking my messages to these people who was afraid of me, to let them know I'm not afraid of you all. So anyway, the marshal sent me a message back. He said, sorry, we could not be in court. You should file a police report about your property immediately. What happened in court? So you see, people, here's the proof. Here's the proof, people. U.S. Marshal Matthew Dumas, sorry, we could not be in court. You should file a police report about your property immediately. What happened in court? So people, they're trying to say right now, no, the DA is saying that I'm on an investigation for trying to kill a federal judge. But the federal marshal, who's supposed to be investigating me, telling me, sorry, I couldn't back be in court. For what? To support me. So there goes the DA claim. Anyway, people, I send Matthew Dumas another email, right, explaining to him what happened in court. And I accuse him, Judge Woodlock, and John of setting me up. Now, John is the boss. Okay, John is the boss of Matthew Dumas. He's the head investigator, right? His name is John Lemmy. So, after I send an email accusing them of setting me up, Matthew Dumas sent this email, see? Matthew Dumas, USMC, Tuesday, April 17, 2012, to Paul Muckle. John and I had nothing to do with this. Judge Woodlock had nothing to do with this. See, people, see right here, Matthew Dumas, Deputy U.S. Marshal, Protective Intelligence Unit, okay? They are the ones who protect the judges, the foxes that protect the wolves, okay? They're bodyguards, they're assassins. So he's sending me an email denying that I had anything to do with me being arrested and charged. Okay. Now, once again, remember the date. This is April 17th. And the tape you all heard at my hearing was the following month, May 2nd. Anyway, I did not believe the U.S. Marshal, right? I didn't believe them that they had nothing to do with this. So I sent them another email, okay, with the police report showing that the police report named John Lemmy as one of the person investigating me. So he sent me another email saying, I noticed the police report have nothing to do with marshals. We do not do this. So people, right here for yourself, right? You all read for yourself with the United States Marshal Services Protective Intelligence Unit is denying that they had anything to do with the police report, that Judge Woodlock had nothing to do with my arrest and my being charged, that the U.S. Marshal had nothing to do with me being charged or arrest. But yet, on May 2nd, this is what the district attorney said.
Mr. Muckle is alleged to have made a number of threats, both to that federal justice. Those threats involve threats to kill. The Federal Marshal Service is currently investigating Mr. Muckle. The details of that are in the original incident report as well as the supplemental incident report, and I've attached both to the motion to revoke.
Okay, now, people, it does not end there. This is the most intriguing part about it, people. This is the most diabolical part about it. I'm about to show you guys. Look at this. Okay, people. Look at this date right here, right? This is the U.S. Marshal investigated report, right? report of investigation. Date of report, October 17, 2011, right? Okay. This report says, Markle continues to post inappropriate videos on YouTube.com pertaining to his case in front of Judge Woodlock. So people, I was telling people on YouTube what was going on, and they were trying to shut me up. I was trying to tell you how they were cheating me, and how they treated me, and how they were disrespecting me and my mother, and how they were robbing you all and ruling wrongfully. So they didn't like it. So they said Markle continued to post inappropriate videos on YouTube pertaining his case in front of Judge Woodlock. They don't know who wired it out, but like I said, this was given to me under the Freedom of Information Act. This is public document. See on top here, it says document filed. This is filed in federal court, so it's public document. Okay, so you all cannot stop me from sharing this. Anyway, he says the USO has been consulted pertaining to the content of the video and has declined to prosecute. So here the people, right? You know who the USO is? The USO is U.S. Attorney Eric Holder's office. Okay? They was consulted about me, what I was saying in my videos, about the government, how they're robbing the people, and using taxpayer dollars to pay off the banks. They notified Eric Holder's office I was doing that, and Eric Holder declined to prosecute me. Okay? As a result of comments that Markle made to the USMS about not allowing eviction to take place at his home without bloodshed, the USM have contacted the Plymouth County Sheriff to advise them that there may be problem if Markle is eventually evicted by their office. The USM have offered assistance due to the USMS rapport with Markle. So you see, people, the U.S. Marshal are acting as intermediate, which is what I wanted. I fed the flock for slaughter. Because while they thought they were setting me up, I was using U.S. Marshal to set them up. Because now look, U.S. Marshal is giving me the report, showing me exactly what took place. The U.S. Marshal set up a judge and the weasels for me. Whosoever did get a pitch shall fall into it. So while they think they were setting a pitch for me, my friend Matthew and John was the one setting the trap for them. Because this is their report, okay? So they're telling me, I didn't know, they're telling me that Eric Holder's office had already declined to prosecute me. So now people, you all see where this is going, right? Eric Holder's office declined to prosecute me, which means that this judge sneaked and went to the state. Because obviously, people, if I had committed a crime, if I had turned to kill this judge, people, would Eric Holder's office have declined to prosecute me? So a light should go on in your head right here. Something is very fishy. So my respect to Eric Holder, you know what I'm saying, he didn't listen to them, he declined. But people, you would think it would end here. It did not. It went on. Here we go down some more. Another report. This is on April 2nd, 2012, a couple of weeks before they arrested me. Okay. PIU, which is Protective Internet Unit, has learned that Markle is now aware that his house is scheduled for a bank action on April 18, 2012 at 11 a.m. Markle has told PIU and in person that PIU, Matthew Dumas, and John Lemmy in person that he will not vacate his home and will not be taken alive. He has stated on numerous occasions that there will be blood and that I will not be taken out of my home alive. Markle has not directly threatened any USMC protectee. So you see, people, you all see that? April 2nd, 2012. Markle has not directly threatened any USMS protectee. However, he has continued to direct behavior rising to the level of icy towards Judge Woodlock and Weasel. Judge Woodlock and Weasel have been, they wipe out, they wipe out the name, but it's Judge Woodlock. Judge Woodlock and Weasel have been in contact with the USO. Here you go again, people. Judge Woodlock, okay, and the Weasel have contacted Eric Holder's office on several occasions. Listen to that, people. Judge Woodlock and Weasel have been in contact with the USO on several occasions. Been in contact with Eric Holder's office, okay, to ask them to prosecute me for what? For exposing the wrongdoing in the federal court. People, these people, the stuff they were doing to me in the federal court, breaking the law, twisting the law, and bending it. Every time I catch them in a trap, they would change the law. I change the rule. I make different ruling, trying to wiggle out of it. So I was making videos exposing them, and they took my videos to Eric Holder office, the USO office, on several occasions. And people hear this. They refuse to take any legal action. People, this is the second report. Okay, the second report you're hearing. First, Eric Holder declined to prosecute. They seen my videos, they read my emails, that's everything. They declined to prosecute, which means that I didn't make any threat to this judge out this weasel. Despite that, 7 months later, April 18th, they went back several occasions. And this time, Eric Holder refused to take any legal action. Okay? As noted in prior updates, Muckle has a long violent history, including firearms offenses, and currently owns 4 pit bulls, canines that reside with him. People, I remember my attorney read my record, and they will know long history of violence. But yet, these people are lying, setting me up. Muckle has a long violent history, including firearms. Yes, I have a firearm charge, but there's no long violent history. What's the violent history? Because someone came in my house with a gun and put it to my head, where my sister was with her baby. He put a gun to my head and tried to rob me, and he got shot inside of me. That's the violent. That's the violent you charged me with. I was found not guilty. First, I was found guilty, and then I fired my attorney, and I appealed it. Okay, and I won 3 times on my own. That's when I learned the law from in jail. That's how I learned the law. And I appealed and I won 3 times. And now he said not guilty. Okay, because this dude came into my house to rob me. He got shot. And I'm the violent one? Please. Anyway, and you are trying to do the same thing that this guy did. There you go. The same thing that this guy did. Come in my house trying to rob me. And when he got shot, it's the same rascal thing you are doing right now. Okay, I'm in my home, and after I show these people what I'm showing you them, they're going to know I'm justified if I take any legal action under the Second Amendment against anyone who comes into my property and try to take me out of it based on your fraud, and your lies, and your corruptions, and your setups. So people, you also saw this federal judge, okay? You also saw this federal judge, the one who gave my house to these banksters. You also saw he has sided with these banksters to set me up, to try to put me in prison. Even though Eric Holder's office found no evidence whatsoever that I threatened his life. Okay? So, Muckle has a long violent history, including firearms offenses, and currently owns 4 pit bulls, canine, that reside with him. He has stated that they will protect him to the death. Which is true, people. My dogs, I grow these dogs since they were babies. Of course they're going to protect me. But we're not going to go out in the street. We're not going to go into the public property. We're in our home, which someone is trying to illegally take from us. Because this judge who resides over the case, my mortgage fraud case, he lied to set me up so that he could get his cut. Okay? Because this judge had a financial interest with these banks, which he later admitted. This judge was heavily invested in these banks. So he started with them to set me up and send me to prison so that they could sell my house and he could get his cut. That's what happened. And that's what I'm proving to you guys. Okay, so now, I say my dad will protect me to the death. The Plymouth County Sheriff's Office and the Brockton PD have been kept in the loop pertaining to the escalating situation with Muckle. It is our understanding that the Plymouth County would ultimately execute an eviction and the Brockton PD would support a bank action. So you see, people, they are teaming up against me. It should be noted that Muckle does not appear mentally or emotionally stable and is clearly prone to passionate outbursts. We do not underestimate his capabilities despite our rapport with him. So people, they do not underestimate my capabilities. At least they admit that, but they're trying to say I'm not mentally or emotionally stable. Of course not. I'm air. I am fire. I am a Gemini. Of course I'm not mentally stable or emotionally stable when you're trying to take something from me. So of course I'm not mentally or emotionally stable when you're trying to rob me. It's unbalanced. It's an unbalanced scale. Who the hell can be balanced when you're trying to wrongfully take something from them? So there you go. There goes my excuse to the jury. I was not mentally or emotionally stable because these people push me to the brink. They make it unbalanced. So anyway, people, you all see that? But people hear the knife in their heart. Here, people, is the knife in their heart. Okay? Remember, I was arrested again on May 2nd. And you hear that deer lying out of his teeth. But listen, people, listen to what the federal marshal is saying. On 4-6-2012, Muckle sent a threatening voicemail as a follow-up to his threatening email to the law firm of the Weasel. But people, that's a lie. There is no threatening voicemail. It does not exist. The voicemail that they're saying are threatening, it does not exist. There is no threatening voicemail. The voicemail are telling them to leave me alone. Okay, the voicemail are in my favor, not their favor. I'm telling them to leave me alone and stop threatening me and stop harassing me. But they call them, they are threatening them. So anyway, he said the voicemail contained numerous serious, directed, and actionable threats. The threats are not directed at any federal protectee. So you see, people, remember the federal protectee is Judge Woodlock. Up to April 6th. No, actually, this is May 24th. Wow, people, date of this report, May 24th, 2012. Okay? And remember, this is after I was arraigned on May 2nd. And the report down here says April 6th. So this report was filed even after the DA accused me. The federal marshal is still saying this. The voicemail contained numerous serious, direct, and actionable threats. That threats are not directed at any federal protectees. Detective Das of Brockton PD, Detective Das of Boston PD have all been briefed. Das was briefed directly by the victim Weasel, which is the DA. The one who you all voice here on the tape, lying on me. No federal protectee were mentioned. Okay, here people. Assistant District Attorney of Suffolk County, who is the Weasel that you all heard talking, has been assigned to the case effective 4-10-2012. So people, 4-10-2012, this Weasel prosecutor knew that Mr. Muckle was not accused of threatening any judge, but yet he went and said that I threatened a judge, and the federal judge just denied it. Muckle was arrested by the Brockton PD and is in state custody pending state charges. There is no further involvement. There is no further federal involvement at this time. Case closed. Okay, so people, so you all see people, the federal government did not find any type of threats that I made to this federal judge. Case closed. When the case closed? May 24, 2012. When was I arraigned? May 2nd, 2012. Yet, people, you heard the district attorney.
Mr. Muckle is alleged to have made a number of threats, both to that federal justice. Those threats involve threats to kill. The Federal Marshal Service is currently investigating Mr. Muckle. The details of that are in the original incident report as well as the supplemental incident report, and I've attached both.
So now, people, Mr. Eric Holder, do you see what I just showed? Mr. Eric Holder, when are you going to send the Federal Marshal to arrest Judge Woodlock and this Weasel? What is it going to take for you to send federal marshal to arrest them for violating my civil rights and my constitutional rights? Because obviously, Eric Holder, if I had made threats to this wolf and this weasel, you would not have declined and then refused to prosecute me. You wouldn't have declined that because you'd have been irresponsible for you to do that. So therefore, that tells me that there were no evidence whatsoever are no merits to their claim that I was making threats to them, because you heard everything. And you declined, then you refused. And several occasions, you did not once or twice, but several occasions. And then this wolf judge and this weasel attorney snuck down to the Boston police and found themselves a fax. A fax was willing to play along. And that fax charged me. That fax took my email and he turned my emails around. And he accused me of threatening to plant water bottle bombs in this federal judge mailbox in his yard and this weasel mailbox in his yard. They charged me with stalking them, threatening to kill them, wiretapping them. Okay, that's what they charged me with. Threatening to kill them. This is what that detective did charge me with. And the federal marshal is saying, no, it didn't happen. And the district attorney, you all heard him. You all heard him, people. He lied on me. He lied on me. Mr. Eric Holder, when are you going to send the federal marshal to arrest Judge Woodlock and to arrest this prosecutor and this weasel and everyone who took part in this great disrespect? He filed his complaint on April 11th, yet on April 10th, a district attorney was assigned to the case. And he was briefed. And no federal protection was mentioned. But yet this assistant district attorney went before a judge and lied out of his teeth to the what? To get Paul Muckle out, to restrain me, a man, to restrain this black man of his liberties. Yo, what you've committed is a federal offense. Okay? This is discrimination. You have used your power and your influence to take a minority homeowner out of his home so that Wall Street could sell it at auction. You have used the power of your office, the power of government. The only thing they didn't have out was their white sheeted hood, their white hoods. They have used that under law. And you have crucified me with it.